very importantly that we cannot forget about this recent tragedy that has happened in Tibet with the earthquake victims. We have to tell the world about the truth about what is happening in Tibet with the earthquake victims. The situation, as we all know, that actually there's probably 8,000 to 10,000 lives have been lost. That's number one. Number two is that the people should know that Tibetans who are helping, the people who are really actually aiding, that all the people who have suffered and died are Tibetans themselves, especially the monks. People should know the truth. And people should know the truth that the Chinese government is pushing them away. And it's a really sad situation. You know, only the media, only the pictures that you see are only disclosed. But we know the truth and we need to expose the truth. Tenzin told me go to YouTube, go to Paiyu, go to Tibet News. You'll see the truth. And it's so important that we have to realize that even with this situation that is going on, we have this tragedy. And still they're suppressing our people and not letting us, you know, do what we should do to help our people. I don't want to criticize and condemn the Chinese government anymore. I think we're here to actually ask for their help. We actually ask them to have some peace of mind and some heart to help our people. And it is like the Tibetan people when the earthquake happened in China. Yeah. The Tibetan people, I know in India, all over the world, all the organizations, they gathered donations and even sent to China, even His Holiness, the Dalai Lama, indirectly donated money to help. So that is where the Tibetans' heart, the people is we have always supported and we have always had this heart of helping all human beings. This is very important. Now this tragedy has happened, and they need help. Tibetans inside of Tibet need help. And like in America, you see how when there's tragedies around the world, in California and Hollywood, they raise millions and millions of dollars, millions, to help. But we need to do our work to still ask, and I encourage any donations and any help. I'm sure there's a Tibetan Relief Fund. I'm sure there's a lot of organizations that are donating that can indirectly donate to help the Tibetans. I think that's really important. And also let the Tibetans know in Tibet that they're not forgotten.
That's right.
That is so important. Now emotionally, mentally, they have actually, you know, in a tragedy like this, when you lost your loved ones and your family members, you become mentally weak. And in this kind of situation, we need to give them encouragement. We need to let them know that we also feel and suffer, and we feel for them, and we pray with them, and doing what we can to help them. I think that's really important. So the message is to the Tibetan people in Tibet that they're not alone. And also the message to the Chinese people, the Chinese government, to let them know that they have to have some type of peace of mind, have some heart to come and help as Tibetans have helped them, and we need to help each other.
Yeah.
I think that's really important, that we all need to work with each other and help each other. And we need to put away on the side, we understand, we know what they have done, history, what they have done to our country. But in this type of tragedies, even though it's negative, we can make it positive.
That's right.
We need to bring people together to make it a positive, to show what human heart is about. This is very important. So I want to say today, actually, I want to officially announce a walk that I want to, that I've, I'm planning. We're going to start on May 8th from Indianapolis, Indiana, and go to Minneapolis, Minnesota. And it's going to go to three major Tibetan communities. That is the Chicago community, the Madison, Wisconsin community and the Minneapolis, Minnesota community. Along the route, we're going to talk to churches, schools, communities, towns, and whatever we can do for the Tibetan cause. We're going to give Tibet awareness. We're also going to let people know that they need to help the Tibetans inside of Tibet on the recent tragedy. We're going to let people know the truth and to donate money to help whatever they can do to aid and help the Tibetans inside of Tibet. That's really important. And I'm happy to announce Denzin Jamala has agreed to join me in this walk, and it's going to be approximately 600 or so some miles. And we will walk the entire route. And I want to say thank you for him to join me. I know it's very hard for any individual to take time out for 30 days or 40 days to join in something like this. But I also feel like we all have families. And I want to say thank you to his wife for at least supporting him. This is very important. We need supporting family members and friends that we can continuing doing what we need to do. And I have also, you know, my responsibilities too, but as an individual, I have a responsibility, not only as a Tibetan, but as an individually, to contribute, do what I can, if I am able to do so. So I want to thank Denzin for joining me, and I want to officially announce that we'll walk for Tibet 2010. We'll start May 8th from Indianapolis, Indiana, and we're going to, this is the day that we have announced it, and I'm just, I hope it brings more continuing awareness about Tibet, and that we strive for a free Tibet. That free Tibet is number one on our issue. We have never given up, we will not give up, even with tragedies, and through history and current devastations of life, we need to still be strong. And we all, as a nation and as people and the world, come together and to continue what the cause is all about. And the cause, and that is that we believe in a free Tibet. We have never given up on that. My father has never given up on that. Our forefathers that came from Tibet have died in Tibet, and the people consistently are continuously being jailed and executed and in prison and died. We cannot forget about them. Still, we cannot forget about them. So we need to let the world know about this situation, continue this, and we want to let the government of China know that we're not going to give up and continue this. And I want to make it very clear that we are not against the Chinese people. This is really very clear. We want to make it fair. We are against the communist system. It's very important. Next to us is Falun Gong. You can see they themselves, you know, they have no freedom of religion in their own country. They've been in the same situation as our country. And they are also expressing their views here in front of the Chinese Council. Let the world know. I see Falun Gong, all the world, protesting, and I also believe and I support them as well.
All right.
So we need to work together with them. So this shows the world that China government has to stop what they're doing. It's not about the money, it's about the human life.
That's right.
That's really important. So thank you. I just want to say, Denzin Jamala, for coming here. And please, you know, we're individual voice, your individual voice. You're, you know, with the cameras, and you can tell 10 people, 100 people, let people know what's happening. Let people know what happened today. And we're going to continue. Hopefully someone could join our walk or have interest, and they can look at our walk. It's at the ambassadorsforwarpeace.org. And then hopefully maybe someone can take some initiative, some type of determination to continue what Denzin Jamala has started. He planted a seed. Now, just like His Holiness has traveled all over the world, he's planted a seed for us. Now we need to do the work to let people know about the truth. So it's very important. Our forefathers have died, came to different countries and started to let the people know. They have planted a seed for us. And we need to continue this for the world, not just a Tibet issue, but a global world issue. We have to let people know the situation. So thank you.